Raban, what time is it?
Time to wake up, brother.
Hey, what is it?
Karen?
Ilya? Why a conference call? What's going on?
My love, my brother. I called early so I could warn you both.
Warn us? What about?
You both are aware of the storm yesterday's announcement has created.
Yeah, there was hardly a way around it with social media. I still don't quite get how you pulled that off. These photos, how did you get them? Were the shelter's cameras still working? Is this why you kept that old notebook?
Don't rack your brains over it. I only did the necessary thing to expose the lies of the national beholder. Now, with the world seeing the beholder for what it really is, and finally shifting their attention to the people's voice, I'm ready to take the next. This evening, I will send out a provocation against President Puppet. Narcissistic and self-centered as he is, he won't be able to ignore it.
Raban, honey, what are you getting yourself into? You don't have to do this.
I'm not getting myself into anything. I have always been right at the center of it.
What is this going to achieve? What do you want?
What do I want? What do I want? I want my country back. I called to warn you about the consequences. The people's voice will gain even more attention, and it won't only be from our followers. The nation's government, Kassert's close allies, nationalists and patriots, they will all try to hurt me, find an excuse to arrest and extradite me, but I won't give them any reason to. And you won't either.
Of course not.
Leave us out of your plans, Raban. We want nothing to do with them.
Don't you understand? It's not my choice. They are not giving me an option.
There's always a choice.
No, not always. I'm relying on you both. If there is any weakness between us, they will find it, and they will exploit it. You are the only people that I trust. The only people that matter to me. I've got work to do now. Goodbye.
Karen, are you...
Yeah, I'm... I can't. Let's not talk now, please.
Okay. In case you do want to talk, though, you...
I do. Bye, Ilya.
Bye.
Thank you.
Karen, I didn't mean to...
Raban, I don't have the time right now.
Where are you? Why is it so noisy?
I'm at the Circle Mall. Just arrived.
What for?
Going after Nina. Like I said, she needs me. She should be right here. She told me she was at the plaza.
Guess what? She probably told you a fake location so she could avoid you. Did she even ask for your help?
No, but she is a very vulnerable person. She's just too proud to admit it. Damn this woman, what is wrong with her? I cannot believe she would blatantly lie to me. We were making progress.
Maybe Nina is still working for the nation. Maybe they placed her in your care to drive a wedge between you and us.
Don't be ridiculous. She hates the government even more than you do. You two would get along famously.
She knew you would come after her. Out there, completely exposed. Think about it.
You should hear yourself talk. Not everyone is your enemy. You are so paranoid.
Karen, listen to me. Get out of there. I don't like this. It all feels very wrong.
To you, everything feels wrong. Always. There is...
Karen? Karen! My dear followers, it might come as a surprise to you, but you aren't the only ones who are listening to me. You are not the only ones watching me. The government has been after me for a long time, snooping and prying into my personal life in a feeble attempt to discredit me. That much I was aware of, and I treaded carefully day and night, but even I could not have anticipated the methods they would resolve to. Instead of attacking me, their declared enemy, they went for my poor wife, Karen, who has always stood both loyally and supportive by my side, has been cowardly assaulted. She was lured into the Circle Mall, straight into one of the Bonton bombings the government fails to stop again and again, or should I rather say, didn't want to stop. Now she has been hospitalized, barely clinging to her life. And for what? To frighten me? But I will not shut the people's voice down. Neither now nor ever. I owe it to you, my supporters, to speak out loud what needs to be said. I won't allow anyone to intimidate me. No, I will not stop. I will fight back, and more furiously than ever before. I will go after them, just as they went after my wife. I will pick their precious lies apart one by one and expose their misdeeds so they are plain to see for everyone. All of you shall be witnesses for the truth.